Okay, sup guys, I need to add a little thing about my Printf video. So, one of my subscribers, one of you guys, mentioned that the malloc is not a system call, it's a library call. It's included in the standard library, which means that I shouldn't have used it in my challenge with Printf. So today I'm going to try to come up with a different solution with regards to malloc. So first I need to tell you a little bit about how malloc works. So if we take a look at the memory of a process, this is the entire virtual memory space that gets allocated when you start a process, like a program. At the bottom here, in brown, we have the data segment and the BSS segment with initialized and uninitialized data, such as constants and things like static variables and stuff like that. We also have a text segment. And that is our code. So then we have the heap, and the heap is the dynamic memory which we can control with a library call such as malloc. And at the top here we have the stack, and the stack is growing downwards, and the heap is growing upwards. And in the in between here we have a blank space. We have uninitialized memory, which both the stack and the heap uses. Okay, so every time you do an allocation, so let's say you use malloc to allocate 1500 bytes, and then you'd make another allocation and maybe a bigger allocation and then a smaller again, and malloc needs to keep track of all these different allocations. And so the heap is growing upwards when we do these allocations. And one special structure, the break. So the break is the demarcation line between the top of the heap and the uninitialized data segment. So this is moving upwards when we do these allocations. But then we will give one of these back, so we free this allocation, and then the break will be moved downwards. And if we free this allocation, if we free this allocation, then the break will move down again. And if we allocate more memory, then it would be moving up again. But what if we give back, if we free this one, then the break will not move, because it only moves when you give back something located on the top of the heap. So the next time you will do a memory allocation, malloc will check if any of these holes fit. So perhaps you're asking for more memory than any of these holes can accommodate. Then you will allocate it on the top of the heap and the break will move. But if you make a smaller allocation, then it will fill this hole instead, and the break won't move. So basically, we can conclude that malloc is aware of these data structures that corresponds to these memory allocations, and it's a quite advanced function to keep track of all this stuff. But the kernel only has to be aware of the top of the heap. So the actual syscall is called sbreak. It's spelled like this, S-B-R-K. And you give one argument, and that is how much you want it to either move upwards, the break, if it's a positive number, and the negative number will move it down again. And if you give it a zero, then you will just it will be returning the current memory address of the break line. So this makes it possible for us, I think, I haven't tried it yet, but to create a function macro, which we could call like, let's call it malloc 2, and it takes the same argument as the regular malloc. So if we want 10 bytes of data, we do like this. And what will happen then is that this macro will just call sbreak and move the break 10 bytes upwards and return the memory address of the old break, which is the start of the allocation. So basically it behaves just like the library called malloc in this case. The problem is if we want to free a specific hole, that won't really work because we're not aware of all the allocations. But we could make it like this, as long as we don't mix the real malloc with our macro version. We could create another macro, which we could call free all, which basically just does sbreak and minus x, where x is the total amount of memory which we have allocated using this macro. So that is the solution I want to try out. So we have two options. We can allocate memory and it will save it to a global state how much we have allocated in total, and then we just free all of it at the same time. Okay guys, let's see if we can turn this into code. I will just log into my server real quick and touch my screen, and I'll create a new file. Let's call it malloc2.h. And we need a global variable which knows about the memory allocation. So it'll be an unsigned, let's make it an int. Perhaps in a later version we'll make it a bigger structure, but this will work for now. And let's just call it something like alloc, like this. And then we need two functions, or rather function macros. So let's begin with our malloc function. I will define this as malloc2, and we'll give an x, and the only thing we'll do is moving the S break like this. And then we will increase the allocation by X as well. That's all. And when we free this memory all at once with our free all function, and this will not take in an argument, and what this will do is it will move the S break to minus alloc, and it will zero alloc, and this should be all, I think. I need to check where to find that system call, by the way. S-break. It's in the unistd.h. So let's put the include here as well. Like so. And let's test it with our printf. And if you haven't seen my printf video, please check out the creating your own printf that I released, I don't know, a couple of days ago. So instead of unistd, we will include our local malloc2.h like this, and then I will search for malloc and change this to malloc2 like so, and I will search for free. And here we free the P. Let's see. Free P. I think I will remove this. No, let's think. No, I think it will work if we do free all here, actually. And we'll go to any next occurrences. Okay, there are none. Great. Let's see what happens. Make clean. And we will make printf. It compiles. And we will just run it. The magic number is 5010. Congrats. Okay, so we have successfully created an own very simple and naive implementation of malloc, but it works fine without any external libraries at all. And we've included it in the printf, which is now completely free of any external libraries. And sorry for the sound quality in this episode. This is a bonus episode, and I needed to use another computer with a worse microphone. But I hope you learned something from this. Anyway, thanks for watching, and thanks for today.